Hey y'all, welcome to another WordPress Wednesday. My name is Corey Ashton here in San Antonio, Texas at WebTegrity. We are a group of WordPress nerds in love with all things WordPress, helping you improve your online marketing. So this YouTube channel is every single Wednesday we're producing some sort of great video like this, so be sure to subscribe. And today we're gonna dive right in to how to hide your footer or maybe even your sidebar inside of your WordPress website. Super simple, but it does require a little bit of magic. Well, nerd code. Come on, I'll take you in and show you how it's done. The question actually came in asking specifically how to hide it inside of the 2017 theme. So I'm gonna show you how to do that, but this pretty much applies for any theme out there. So this is the example of the brand new 2017 theme, and this is the footer they have down here right now in this specific example. However, you can simply just remove these items inside of your widget area. So if you go to Appearance and go to Widgets, you just want to be sure that these two widget boxes here, footer one and footer two, are just completely empty. If you do that then, like on my example here, all you will see then is Powered by WordPress. This will sit right here, and that's where your content would have sat if you'd had anything filled into these two widget boxes. However, if you even still want this gone, how do you do it? How do you just completely hide the whole darn thing? I'm going to show you here because it's a better example so you can see the content actually go hide. What I want you to do is right mouse click and I want you to inspect element. Right now I'm using the browser Firefox, but this works inside of Chrome as well. So when you inspect the element, what we're trying to do here, don't panic. I know this is a lot of nerd code, but follow with me here. What we're trying to do is find anything over here that says footer. So we're just going to do a search. We see the word footer there. And then we see the footer here. And what I want you to see is when we hover over footer, it actually highlights behind me here the entire section of that footer. So that we know that this div class right here affects that whole footer. So now here's what we do. Now that we know what it is here, we can come over here to this side and see what they've named it in our style sheet. So this whole section is named .site-footer. And we can do a quick test here and see if this is in fact the area that it is addressing. Check this out. So this is our magic that I was talking about. It's one line of code that just simply says hide it or display none. So here's what we have to do now. You notice it's gone completely. So here's what we have to do. We have to grab the name so we know exactly what it is, .site-footer. I'm gonna copy that onto my clipboard. Super simple. So I've got that on my clipboard now. Now I'm gonna dive into a custom CSS box. Again, super easy. We're just gonna copy and paste. That's all we're gonna do. So inside of the 2017 theme, you have this customized area underneath appearance. Inside of that, you have additional CSS options. This is the little area we want to go into. So you're going to put your cursor down below anything here. We're going to paste in that site footer. We're going to do a curly bracket, enter down, and end curly bracket. And then we're just simply going to type display colon none, semicolon. There you go. That's it. This right here overwrites anything else in the author's theme and immediately hides that whole section. So now we're going to push the save and publish option right there. Once we come back to our front side of our website, you will see as I click refresh that that is totally hidden. As I scroll down, I can't go any further and our entire footer is hidden. So this display none option, the reason why I wanted to say that is all you have to do is find the div class or the section on your website that you want to hide. You can hide elements, we can hide whole columns, you can hide anything by just simply using the display none inside of a custom CSS area. I hope that helps you. If you have further questions, put them in the thread below and we'll do our best to answer them for you. Hope you're having a great WordPress Wednesday. I'll see you next time. Bye y'all.